This video clip explains how to set the graphic override style in the Graphic Override Rules Dialog of ARCHICAD 20. When defining graphic override rules, the first step is the definition of graphic override criteria, which will select elements. The override style, of which the 2D and 3D representation of these selected elements will be overridden with, can be defined in the Override Style panel of the Graphic Override Rules dialog. The Override Style panel may look familiar, and for good reason, since it's a continuation and enhancement of the Renovation Override Styles dialog of previous versions. Renovation Override Styles are now handled by Graphic Override Rules in ARCHICAD 20, as mentioned in several other clips in this playlist. The panel consists of checkboxes on the left side, and corresponding settings fields to the right of these checkboxes. As a general rule, corresponding settings fields become enabled only when a given checkbox is checked. The first item in the Override Style panel is the Line Type checkbox. Check it to override the line type of elements and use the line type selection list to its right to select the override line type. Similarly, check the Line Marker and Text Pen checkbox to override the pen of line marker and text elements. Use the pen selection to its right to select the override pen. The third item is the Fill Type checkbox. Check it to override the fill type of elements and use the Fill Type selection list to its right to select the override fill type. There are also three buttons to its right, and by using these, you can individually apply fill type overrides to, from left to right, drafting fills, cover fills and uncut fills, and cut fills, respectively. Please note that at least one of these three buttons is always activated. The Show Skin Separators checkbox becomes enabled only when the fill type checkbox is checked, and the Override Cut Fill Types button is activated as well. If you check this checkbox, skin separator lines of composite and complex profile elements will be displayed, while unchecking the checkbox will hide them. The next item is the Fill Foreground Pen checkbox. Check it to override the Fill Foreground Pen of elements, and use the pen selection list to its right to select the override pen. There are also three buttons to its right, with which you can individually apply pen overrides to, from left to right, drafting fill foregrounds, cover fill and uncut fill foregrounds, and cut fill foregrounds, respectively. At least one of the three buttons is always activated. The next item is the Fill Background Pen checkbox. Check it to override the Fill Background Pen of elements and use the pen selection list to its right to select the override pen. There are also three buttons to its right, which you can use to individually apply pen overrides to, from left to right, drafting fill backgrounds, cover fill and uncut fill backgrounds, and cut fill backgrounds, respectively. At least one of the three buttons is always activated. The next item is a pair of radio buttons which become enabled when either the line marker and text pen checkbox or the fill foreground pen checkbox is checked. If you activate the upper override pen color only radio button, only the color of override pens will be applied to the pens of line, marker and text elements and fill foreground pens. However, if you activate the override pen color and thickness radio button, both the color and thickness of override pens will be applied. This is an option that had been requested by ARCHICAD users in the past. Finally, the last item is the surface checkbox. Check it to override the surface of elements and use the surface selection list to its right to select the override surface. There are also two buttons to its right which you can use to individually apply surface overrides to, from left to right, uncut surfaces and cut surfaces, respectively. At least one of these two buttons is always activated. Please note that the Uncut Surface Override will be applied to all uncut surfaces of elements. They cannot be applied to individual uncut surfaces of these elements. When you have finished setting the desired override style for the selected graphic override rule, click the OK button to leave the dialog and apply changes.